G'day Internet, and welcome back to another video. So as you know, recently I've been working on my Commodore 64, and so far we've managed to get it working, clean up the keyboard, we fixed the case and also built a power supply for it. So that's it, kind of, it's all working and it's happy. But we should probably do one small upgrade to it, and that's add JiffyDOS, which really, really speeds up the disk access from the old 1541 disk drive. So that's what we're going to take a look at today. So here we are back with the Commodore 64. And if we get rid of the keyboard, you'll first notice this isn't the board that we were working on recently. I was trying to chase down some video issues and this board ended up in this machine. And also ignore the LumaFix because it really didn't help much at all. But this is a fairly average longboard for a Commodore 64. Now, I've simply gone out and purchased a ROM switcher. It is simply this here. Most of it has got to do with adapting the, 24-pin EEPROM that is here in U4 to a 28-pin, and this is a 27C512 EEPROM. And then it's got some electronics and a little pad here which changes the default. This is set to default JiffyDOS and the normal kernel, which is elsewhere in the address space. This is literally just a case of popping the kernel ROM out and putting this in, and then we've got a little bit of soldering to do. So all we need to do is pop this out carefully. And pop this guy in. Right, we now have two wires that we need to solder in. One goes to the reset line and the other one goes to the restore line. So for the reset line, it's the simplest place to get to it is it's pin 3 on the user port. And if I just move that slightly out of the way, there is actually a solder pad just behind the actual edge connector here. So if we drop some solder onto it, and take the one for our reset line, which is quite long. I think I might trim that to about there. And put that guy in. Kind of tuck it around between the CIAs. That doesn't look too bad. And now we have the restore line, and it can be soldered down to the right-hand side of R41, which is down here. And how do I want to do this? I guess it doesn't really matter. So that's just a little long for my liking. Let's get some solder on the end of R41. And get this guy in place. And we're good. All right, let's see if this, you know, worked. So, all things going well, I should turn this on and JiffyDOS should boot. And we do. We have JiffyDOS 6.01. Awesome. All right. So if I switch this off and hold the restore key down, it should boot into the default kernel. And it does. Right. The switcher is working. But just having JiffyDOS in the Commodore is no good unless your disk drive also has it. Now, if you've got something like a Pi 1541, that's really simple. You just load up the JiffyDOS BIOS file and off you go. But if you've got an actual 1541, you need to be able to put the ROM into it as well. So let's take a look at that. So here is my trusty 1541. If we pull the cover off. And here is the ROMs here. Now this is a little odd one because this is a super short board. And this is actually the one that Mark from the Retro Channel fixed up for me, or tested, because it wasn't working for me. Now, with this, this actually has a small daughter board in it. And as soon as I can find the screwdriver I had a second ago, we can carefully lift this out. And essentially what this is the original ROMs were a lot smaller, I believe, than what came on later 1541s. So this is basically gives you a larger EEPROM, essentially. Right. But that comes out. Now, I have made myself a wee little converter board that also doubles as a switch. I will put a schematic and the information I found down in a link in the description. But essentially this does two things. It adapts again, 24-pin EEPROM to a more common 28-pin, and also allows us to switch between the bottom address space and the next address space up, because you can switch between the default kernel and the JiffyDOS kernel. The next thing we need to do is desolder the 901 chip from the daughter board and solder on the little adapter thingy that I made to it. The next thing we're going to do is mount and wire up the switch. Right, with everything put back together, we should probably actually do some benchmarking and see if any of this was worthwhile. The computer is booted to JiffyDOS, but if I query the drive is running the standard kernel, so we should get normal speeds. So if I simply get this ready and get a stopwatch going, I have Donkey Kong Arcade in the drive, and if we go Okay, that took a minute 36 to get to the ready prompt. So if we reset that, turn everything off, change the drive to JiffyDOS, turn everything back on, and I'm going to have to be careful here because I'm going to have to hit stop as the ready prompt comes up because JiffyDOS will just load. So that basically took 18 seconds. So needs to say, noticeably faster. Well, there you go. That's JiffyDOS installed in both the computer and the drive. And I think that quick benchmark really does show how much faster JiffyDOS speeds things up. And it's not just the speed. There's also a whole bunch of really easy to use keyboard shortcuts to save typing in a whole bunch of normal commands, even just for formatting a disk, things like that. So it's not just the speed, it's also, well, I guess it's speed as well, because it speeds things up when you're trying to format and copy disks and all that kind of stuff. If you found this useful, I'd appreciate a thumbs up and hit subscribe while you're there, and I'll see you in the next one.